One of our young campers was on a boogie board. A wave knocked him off, and he actually got bit. There was another incident at Sailor's Haven. A young lady, the boy that was in our camp was 13. The young lady at Sailor's Haven was 12. I know that her dad's been already giving interviews and everything. But both of these young kids, thank God, are okay.
It may be Shark Week on the Discovery Channel, but here in New York, we're dealing with a real thing. Back-to-back shark attacks off the coast of Long Island. That was Angie Carpenter, supervisor of the town of Islip, confirming that two children were bitten while swimming in the waters off Fire Island last week. Local officials later confirmed that these bites were, in fact, those of a shark. The children, a 13-year-old boy and a 12-year-old girl, who were bitten in separate incidents off Atlantique Beach and Sailor's Haven, received minor injuries, and though shaken up, they're recovering well, according to their parents and officials. Emergency medical personnel removed a confirmed shark's tooth from the boy's leg, but due to the fragmented state of the tooth, experts were unable to determine just exactly what type of shark it was that attacked him. The tooth has since been returned to the boy at his request. While shark sightings aren't uncommon off New York beaches, attacks in our area are considered rare. In fact, since 1837, only 10 shark attacks have been reported in New York, 15 in New Jersey, and one in Connecticut. So, to separate fact from fiction regarding shark attacks in our region, MetroFocus host Jenna Flanagan spoke with John Forrest Dolan, director of the New York Aquarium and vice president of the Wildlife Conservation Society. She began the conversation by asking him if there really was a dorsal fin sea monster lurking just off our coast.
Well, there are sharks off the shore of New York, which is actually great news, I think. There's over 26 species of sharks. So what we tend to think about as a monolith, right, the white shark, mm-hmm. Jaws, all of that, is actually a very varied and diverse fauna of sharks, which is great news for all of us. So the truth is, there are sharks out there.
But let's go back a little bit to the fact that you were saying that this is good news that there's actually sharks in the water. Tell me about the shark population, at least in this part of the North Atlantic.
Yeah, well, so it's very interesting because the truth is, sharks as apex predators, their presence or absence is an indication of habitat health, mm-hmm. and ecosystem health, right? So when we have a solid population of these predators, they keep the entire sort of ecotome in good shape, right? Because as apex predators, they're working down the chain to keep all of these animals healthy. So when we see sharks, when we see a healthy population of sharks in these waters, we know two things. We know that the habitats are in good shape, mm-hmm. and we know that the regulations and the laws that we have passed through the years to protect these animals and protect other marine wildlife are working, and that's a really great thing.
Well, that was actually one of my questions, is that it's not just about protecting the sharks, it's also got to be about protecting the food that they prey on, because some of that is some of the same food that we like to fish for.
That's right. When you see, again, if you see sharks, you're seeing healthy populations of those animals that fishermen like to go out after, mm-hmm. right? So stripers, bluefish, all of these animals that we associate with recreational fishing and joy out on the water, right? Well, those are the same animals that if you see sharks, you know there's healthy populations of. So we see that these regulations are working. And that's also why the Wildlife Conservation Society's New York Aquarium and others are out there studying these animals, because we need to understand habitat use, we need to understand the migration patterns, and we need to understand how we can help protect these animals, because in doing so, we're protecting a vibrant economy right here in New York.
Very quickly, and I kind of want to go a little bit deeper, but to also understand a little bit further, because I understand that the health of the coral reefs actually is sort of like a, maybe not a ground zero, but a baseline for building the health of the shark population.
Yeah, well, again, any place that we have an affinity for in a marine habitat, mm-hmm. right, and coral reefs being first amongst them, right, they're bright, they're colorful, they're diverse, we all have these really positive associations with them. Sharks are important to the health of those places. Again, as the apex predator, they're keeping the entire ecosystem in balance and they're keeping it healthy. So when we think, oh, I love coral reefs, mm-hmm. on some level, what we're also saying is, oh, I think sharks are really important and I want to protect sharks, because in doing so, we're protecting all of these places. So when there are healthy populations of reef sharks, you have healthy coral reefs. Similarly, when there are healthy populations of both the inshore coastal sharks, like the sandbar that we saw, and others, we know that we have healthier and more productive waters here in New York.
All right. Well, that's all very good news to hear, especially during Shark Week, when I know that we tend to look for that dorsal fin on the horizon in the water. Listen, John, thank you so much for joining us.
It's been great to be here. Thanks, Jenna.
Thank you.